Okay, welcome back students. Okay, so with respect to our last class with shell programming, we had come across with this usage of logical and logical or as an operator. Okay, so if any two commands are being separated or else are being divided across with this logical and logical or, always keep in mind logical and says that both of the commands should have an exit status as success. Okay, only then the output has been shown to you. Okay, else the output either of one fails, so it means that entirely both of those commands will not be executed at all. Okay, so that is one. Let us come across with one more, which says logical OR. Okay, logical OR as an operator says that either of one, okay, if at all it is now, like for example, when it is coming on its way, okay, and it is success, okay, so it does not enter into the other part. Okay, so else it can be either, if at all it does not find this one, assume, okay, it does not find this one over here, so at that time it shifts across with the next particular command there, okay, and it prints with the execution of the other command there. Okay, so this is with your logical and logical OR there. Okay, so let us try using these things in our shell programming there. Okay, so with usage of your logical AND or logical OR, they both go well with conditional statements there. Okay, control block statements. So in that, one of the conditional statements which you have come across in your C as a program, or else in your Java also you have come across, okay, that's with the conditional statement called as if statement there. Okay, if goes in an pattern or else in an structure there. Okay, what's the pattern or the structure for that? If a command is successful, then execute a series of command, else execute the other series of commands there. Okay, and then you are ending that particular if there. Okay, so that is here, you can just see here, if a command is successful, then execute these commands, else execute the other series of commands. And here in script, always when you use if, you have to end it with and reverse of it, that is fi. Okay, then one more is simple without usage of else, that is if the command is successful, then execute a series of commands, then end your respective if there. Okay, one more says across as if command is successful, then execute a series of command. If at all you are going across with a nested if condition, that is else if condition, so at that time use it as elif, command is successful, then execute a series of command, else execute a series of commands. Always end your if with an fi. Okay, these are syntaxes for your command called out as, that is usage of your if statement there. Okay, always keep in mind, if it starts out with if, that's with a small letter, okay, then ends with a reverse of fi. Okay, you can just come across with an example, I'll tell you with the same. Okay, these are some things about if. If also requires a then is a keyword here, if is a keyword. Okay, it evaluates the success or failure of the command that is specified in the command line. Okay, it succeeds the sequence of commands following it is executed. Okay, if command fails, then the else statement is executed. Okay, every if is closed with a corresponding fi. Okay, you can just come across with this example here. Okay, so I'll tell you more in elaboration in the further classes regarding this. Okay, so for time being, okay, you can just come across here what I have done here. Okay, I'll just make a small change over here. Just a second. So that if I'll make these changes na, so that it will be helpful for you to read it accordingly also. Okay, else it becomes little bit tough for you to enhance it. Okay, so that I'm making you guys easy with the reading there. Okay, else if, then and lastly end with the if. Okay, so this is how your statement looks. Okay, so here A is equals to 10, B is equals to 20. What is this? I am assigning these values to these variables called out as A and B. Okay. So when I'm assigning these values to A and B, this is a shell script which I have taken as an example. If dollar A, what do you mean by dollar A? Evaluation of this A, that is value of this A is been taken there. That is dollar A is now 10. Okay, I am using 2 equals to sign. Okay, keep in mind if has a small bracket which I am using, and within that the conditional statements are used there. Okay, if dollar A double equals to dollar B, okay, then echo A is equal to B. I am printing a message there. Okay, if this is not equal to this, okay, else if. Okay, else if dollar A, okay, this is an now, like for example, you are using the operator called as greater than or less than. Okay, in shell script you are using these phrases called as hyphen GT. GT stands out for greater than. Okay, in my next slide I am telling in more detail regarding these numeric comparisons there. Okay, hyphen GT dollar B, then echo A is greater than B. Okay, else if, one more else if I have taken, dollar A hyphen LT dollar B. So what do you mean by this? Hyphen else if dollar A hyphen LT dollar B, it means that it is and lesser than, then echo A is lesser than B. Okay, else, onto the other side, I say that else echo none of the conditions have been met and I have ended my if condition here. Okay, so I'll just use an ennote here so that it will be easier for you guys. Okay, so here you can just see the important things are fi, then is a keyword, else is a keyword, okay, else if is a keyword, okay, else if is a keyword again over here, then is a keyword, then is a keyword, okay, if is a keyword. Okay, wherever if is there you can find that there is a then. Okay, and where I have with the okay, where I have if here, okay, if dollar A equal to dollar B, then, okay, as soon as if is pertained with this then, I am having and conditional statements which are being run here, okay, else if, okay, E-L-I-F, okay, as you had used in C or something, you are using it as else if there, okay, but here I am using just it, just a keyword called out as E-L-I-F, okay, else if dollar A hyphen GT dollar B, then echo A is greater than B. Okay, else if dollar A hyphen LT dollar B, that is we want to say that it is less than. Okay, these are again keywords to you. In my next class I'll tell you regarding that, in the next slides I'll tell you regarding that. Okay, so what is the output now? What is dollar A? Dollar A has a value called out as 10, dollar B has a value called out as 20. 10 equal to 20, this is not executed. Okay, else if it, the command comes across here, else if dollar A greater than dollar B, is dollar A greater than dollar B? No, even that condition is not there, then this condition, then this statement will not be executed. Then the last one, else if dollar A hyphen LT, is dollar A that is 10 less than 20? Yes, this is yes. So then echo A is lesser than B. Okay, that message will be printed to you on the screen. Okay, this is a small example here. Okay, in my next slides I'll tell you more in detail. Okay, so I recommend before I go across with this, before I shift with this case, let us come across with this conditional, let us come across with this test there. Okay, so either there are two things what you guys can do. Okay, one is you can use this test as a command. Okay, else you can use these brackets, both are one and the same. Okay, at any command window, okay, if at all you use this keyword called out as test, or else if you use anything within the square bracket, it is said that it is used for evaluation purpose. Okay, now here I have just now taken an example. Okay, here if I can elapse these brackets there. Okay, instead of this, what I can use is I can use a command called out as test. If test dollar A equal to dollar B, I can even do that. I can use the term called out as test there. Okay, so here with an example I'll tell you. Okay, so this test as an operator, okay, test as a command uses certain operators to evaluate the condition on its right and returns either true or false exit status there. Okay, always keep in mind, let it be test,
or else let it be square bracket, both of them evaluates along according to the exit status as that. Okay, exit statuses are being shown to you. That is exit status as true or as exit status as false there. Okay, so here your test works well with three ways there. What are the three ways? One is called out as numeric comparison. The second one is called out as string comparison. And the third one is called out as file test. Okay, you can either use it with numeric or else string or else with file test there. Okay. For numeric comparisons, what are you using? For numeric comparisons, we use the operators called out as we use double equals to. Okay, else we can use hyphen EQ. Okay, hyphen NE. Hyphen NE stands out for not equal to. Hyphen GT stands out for greater than. Hyphen GE stands out for greater than or equal to. I am using two expressions here. Hyphen LT, it stands out for less than. Hyphen LE, it stands out for less than or equals to. These are the things which I can use accordingly provided with the two operands here. Okay. One operand will be over here. One more operand will be here. Any comparison, any numeric comparison being done, I can use these operators instead of using these as 2 equals to. Okay. Else it is not equals to. Okay. You are using such kind of operator. So it is apart from that. It is greater than or equals to. Okay. It is less than, okay, it is less than or equal to, okay. Instead of these things, I am using these operators there, okay. This is an example, you can just come across. For numeric comparisons, dollar x equals to a, x equals to 5, y equal to 7, z equals to 7.2, okay. So I can use it as test dollar x hyphen eq dollar y, okay. Echo dollar question mark. What is this dollar question mark? Just recall yourself. This is one of the command line arguments. Okay, what it will return back? It will return back the exit status of the previous command. Okay, exit status of the previous command is, what is the previous command? It is the previous command. Okay, what it is testing? It is testing whether x is equals to y or what. What is x value? X value is 5, y value is 7. Okay, is 5 equals to 7? No. So what's your exit status? Exit status is equals to 1. Okay. Similarly, I have used test dollar x hyphen lt dollar y. Echo dollar question mark. So what does it define back? It returns back to you the exit status there. Okay. So E is dollar x less than dollar y? Yes. So you'll be expecting with the exit status, call it as 0. Okay. Then comes dollar z greater than dollar y. Okay, so dollar z, it is 7.2. what's dollar y? It is 7. 7.2 is greater than 7. Okay, 7.2 is greater than 7 there. Okay, I hope so. Somewhere there's a wrong here. Okay, 7.2 is, okay, we are expecting across with the output called out as 0 for this, because your 7.2 is greater than 7. Okay, so ultimately you will receive an output exit status called out as 0. Okay, it's a true one. Okay, so I have made a mistake over here. Okay, just you also, if at all you are testing it on your systems, you can test it. Okay, this is with numeric comparison then. Okay, so with this numeric comparison to be known here, you can just see that everywhere I have used a test here. Okay, either you can use a test or else directly you can use within these brackets. Bracket called out as dollar x. Okay, dollar x, then it can be hyphen eq. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm unable to annotate it properly. Dollar y. Okay, you can write it like this also. Okay, no issues with that. Either that way or else this way. Okay, so with a small known to these things, okay, so what you guys do is, okay, write down a shell script. Okay, I'll give you as a work. Okay, write a shell script to read three numbers. Okay, to read three numbers and print those three numbers, okay, and find whether the three numbers are amongst the three numbers which happens to be the greater, and print appropriate messages. Okay, got to know my question? Okay, write a shell script to read three numbers, okay, and find out which happens to be the greatest one. using numeric comparisons, okay, using numeric comparisons, find the greater than and print appropriate messages. Okay, let us have a small shell script on this, and later I'll continue across with the next one. Okay, thank you.